This is the STD. It's a pretty good pattern. I haven't killed on it, but I've taken some really nice fish and some big fish at that. You're going to start by tying in a foam strip that you've pre-cut beforehand. And you're going to lock that in at the head and bring it all the way to the back. And then you're going to reach for your dubbing. I prefer to use an ice dubbing, something flashy. And you can experiment in color. You can use all different shades of tan, brown, or green. And, you know, some colors might work better for certain species of caddis. Go ahead and dub this in. And dub it in just like you would that of a caddis larva. You want it fairly sparse because you're going to be pulling the foam over the dubbing. And that's going to give it a nice two-tone to the body. I've done well with these using all different kinds of methods of nymphing. It's good for right angle nymphing, and you can fish these without a bead high up in the water column if you think the fish are taking a little higher in the water column, and that's also been effective, so it's fairly versatile. Go ahead and lock your foam off at the top near the bead, and at this point you're going to put in some partridge. You can use, you know, a hackle if you wanted to here. You can really, you know, kind of use whatever you want. I use the partridge and I don't pommer it in. This step's probably the hardest part of the fly. You're going to take your partridge and you're going to put it flush on your finger. And then you're going to take your scissors and you're going to open them up slightly and point in and try to just grab the stem and cut right into your finger. Don't cut yourself, but right into your finger. And that's going to create a V in the partridge. You're going to flip that upside down. Make that a little wider here. There we go. You're going to flip this upside down and tie the V in, so that the curvature is facing up. Just like this. And notice with your right hand, you're going to sort of pinch the fibers on the side of the fly to hold them in place as you wrap. And when you wrap, you want to get in maybe 2-3 good turns. What's going to happen is your partridge is going to spin a little bit. But that's okay, cuz you're basically going to take your fingers and kind of move the tips underneath the fly. It's shown here. You want the majority. That's why I don't pommer, is cuz I don't want it all around the fly. I just want it on the bottom, because that's what the natural is gonna kind of look like. So again, use your free hand to kind of shape those tips, and then just lock in the thread, and that's gonna hold it in place. After you're done with this, you can either whip the fly and be done with it, or you can put just a little bit of dubbing over your wraps, which is a nice little touch. Most of the time I do it. When you're done dubbing, you're done. That's it. So again, you're not going to kill on this fly, but if there's a lot of caddis activity, throw it in your rotation. You should take a few fish and maybe a really good one. So have fun with this one.